I have a series on this channel where I disclose to you guys 100% transparency on what I hold in my retirement portfolio, how I'm building up that portfolio. And of course, in these videos, I talk about my positions. I talk about percent allocations of each position. And of course, I talk about the dollar amount that I've put in to each of these stocks. And as a result of this series, I get a ton of questions from you guys on, Nick, how do you pick between company A and company B? What exactly do you look for when you decide to add a stock to this portfolio? And just other questions related to my thought process behind building out this portfolio. So what I thought I'd do is create this video here to explain to you exactly what I do to decide if a stock should be added to this portfolio or not. And guys, if you appreciate the transparency here and me disclosing my actual retirement portfolio with you guys, the best way you can thank me is by just hitting that like button down below. Every like helps out the channel tremendously, so I truly, truly appreciate that. All right, so really for this portfolio that I've been building, the goal is simple. I want to create a dividend growth portfolio for my retirement so that when I retire, I have these incredible dividend companies that pay me a consistent stream of income every single month. And picking these companies isn't a joke. I just don't go in and just, you know, this one looks good. I'm just going to add that in. No. There's actually a method that goes behind this. And there's actually some criteria that needs to be met for a stock to be part of this portfolio. Of course, it has to be a dividend stock. Of course, it has to be a stock that's growing its dividend consecutively year over year. And although many companies fit these two criteria, there are other metrics that I look at that may rule those companies out from adding to my portfolio. So the first thing I do before I spend a lot of time researching the company, understanding what they do, their financials, fundamentals, all that stuff, is I look at the health of their dividend. And this will essentially tell me if the dividend that they pay out is stable, is consistent, and is healthy, and I can expect this sort of dividend over the long term. And ideally what I'm looking for is a company that has a good starting yield. Yes, that's important. But what's more important is one that's growing the dividend by at least 7% year over year and has been paying out a consistent dividend over a long period of time. So looking at 3M here, which I think is a good example, there's three key things that I look at. First, the dividend growth, like I talked about, how many years they've been paying out the dividend consecutively. And ideally, I want this as high as possible, guys. I don't want this to be like, you know, 1-2% because that's not really going to make me wealthy over the long run. Now, I do understand that companies have ups and downs. You know, some years they may not grow it as fast as others. But on average, I want to see, like I said, at least a 7% growth. And 3M here meets that criteria with around 11% growth over the last 5 years. The next thing I look at is the payout ratio. And ideally, I want this under a 60% for most businesses. However, this does differ from business to business and sector to sector. But with a company like 3M here, under 60% is ideally what I want. And you can see that they actually pay out around 61.5%, which is slightly higher than my ideal payout ratio here. But in this case, considering they have raised the dividend consecutively for 61 years straight, I can let this slide here for this company. 3M has really proven themselves over time on being able to manage their payout and bring it down over the years. So I am able to make an exception here for this company. Now, if all of this looks good, I quickly glance over to the growth history chart here to see if they've had any cuts to their dividend. And this is especially important during tougher economic times. And we can see here that 3M in this regard looks good with no dividend cuts. All right, great. So that's the first thing I look at. Now, moving on to the second thing, it comes down more to numbers here. And this is in regards to the valuation of the company and how does it look from a fundamental level. Now, I did talk about the historical dividend yield method that I used recently. So if you haven't checked out that video, make sure you do after watching this. I'll leave a link in the description down below. But essentially what I do with this is if you look at 3M again as an example here, we can see its dividend yield history and we can see its current dividend yield compared to its historical average. If we look, we're at pretty much all-time highs here with the current yield with 3M, which is a good sign to me that the stock is potentially undervalued. Inversely, if you're near all-time lows on the current yield, it'd be a sign the stock is potentially overvalued and I would not be looking to add it to my portfolio at this time. Now, if this check is met and we are trading near the highs on the dividend yield here, then I look at my next metric, which is comparing the historical PE of the company versus its forward PE. This would be another kind of metric that I use that gives me an idea if the stock is undervalued, fairly valued, or overvalued. In 3M's case, the historical PE is around an 18. Its four PE is around a 16. So we are technically undervalued by around 12% here on 3M. So this is looking good for me right now. Both of these conditions are met. Dividend yield is near its highs. The four PE is under the historical PE. So now I can move on to look at other fundamentals of the business, like its cash balance, debt load, gross margins, net income, free cash flow, all these other metrics that really show me if this is a healthy, sustainable business for the long term. Ideally, when I look at the cash and debt, I want to see as close to a one-to-one ratio as possible. Of course, the less debt they have, the better. The more cash they have, the better. I also want to look at things like a high gross margin, some strong net income, and growing free cash flows year over year. Cash flows is very important, and especially positive cash flows that are in the billions, because it shows me that the company is able to maintain and sustain growing their dividend over the long term. Okay, so now that I've done all of these analytical things, I've kind of figured that this company looks good from the numbers. Look at the charts, it looks good. All of these metrics look good for a potential investment. I really want to ask myself and challenge myself to think of different reasons as to why this company would face struggles in the next decade or so. Some questions I could ask myself would be, is this a growing company? Is this a growing industry? Are they creating products that will be more in demand in the future or less in demand? How have they performed over the last few economic downturns? Have they struggled? Have they reached a point where they almost went bankrupt? These are all important things to understand before investing in a company. And the reason I really want to challenge myself with these questions and ideally try to find answers for each and every one of these is because if I'm holding a stock for 10, 20, 30 years, I want to make sure that this business is around for that time. I don't want to check my portfolio 30 years from now and find out that company A that I invested in went bankrupt and all of my capital in there went down to $0. That would definitely set me back from my retirement plan and is not the goal for this portfolio. But anyways, if I can really answer these questions with confidence and I'm able to really stand behind this business, the business model, the products that they create, and where I see this company in the future, then that's the final green light that I'm waiting for to actually go out and start building out a position in that stock. Now, this three-step process that I went through with you guys may seem simple, but it is crucial for me to do this for every stock that I choose for that portfolio. And when you're doing your research, you're going to find a lot of companies will meet one or two of these checkboxes. But considering we're at all-time highs right now, more often than not, you're going to find incredible businesses that are not trading at the best valuation right now. So in those cases, I make note of those businesses, I put them on the side of my watch list, and I'm just gonna wait patiently for them to drop to more attractive valuations for me to start building out positions in them. I've already done the research on whether I like the business, all that kind of stuff. So now it's just a matter of waiting for a good valuation on those businesses. And of course, if you haven't followed my retirement portfolio series, check out the link in the description. I will leave a link in there which you can watch every single episode to date. You can kind of see how the portfolio has progressed over the months, and you can see how it's performed versus the S&P 500 as well, how my dividend income keeps increasing in that portfolio, and it's kind of joined me in my journey here for building out my retirement portfolio. Just remember that that portfolio was really created for dividend growth stocks, and a lot of these companies are going to be boring blue chip companies, you know, massive couple hundred billion dollar companies and all that kind of stuff. So they're not going to be your usual exciting growth stocks, but that's okay because this portfolio's goal is for stability, and high growth stocks typically don't provide much stability, which is why I don't include them in that portfolio. Guys, if you enjoyed this video, make sure to drop a like down below and share this video with a friend as well who's thinking of building out a portfolio for themselves as well. I hope you learned something from this, but either way, guys, thank you for joining me. Don't forget to invest positively, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.